All right, I'm back. It is now morning. The moth is still exactly where he is. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go in for like one of these kinds of attacks. So you charge it up, and then you're just gonna one-shot him. I know that's not gonna do like any damage to this thing. So what I'm gonna think of doing is, so I'm gonna use that move. Where is it? Get this out. Maybe shoot him a couple times. If he comes back down, I'm gonna use a bomb. Hopefully that does something. Then in the next video, in this video I'm still playing the cassette tapes. Then I'm gonna what was it that I was gonna do? I forgot already. That's fine. I'll probably think of it. So, all right, ready? 3, 2, 1. Oh, I don't like this thing. Ha. Imagine. Oh, I should probably put it back on my shield. It's like the dumbest idea ever to not have a shield. What's that gonna do? What is that supposed to make that harder for me to see or something? I missed. Oh, I'm dead. That was a really quick death. Did not expect to die that quick. There's my marker. How in the world did I lose my marker? Literally, like, right there. Okay, so... yeah, I wasted an arrow on him. So, I'm not sure if I'm ready for this boss right now. Oh, it gave me a damage non-buff. It gave... I don't remember what it's called. Non-buff, whatever. Alright, I'm back, and, this thing was after me. So, sorry we can't do that. Not gonna kill the moth, I guess. I died almost in an instant. So, what we will do is, so I'm gonna hop back down here to my original base. But this thing is about, then you guys can leave a comment or say what else I should get. Because I don't know what else I should get. I have, like, everything that I don't need or whatever. So, think of that. Yeah, I'll go ahead and... So, if I go to here, window... here it is. So, these are every cassette tape or everything that we need to listen to. So, this will take a little bit. Oh, right.
Practical Technologies, Dr. Wendell Tully, Science Division, Log 87.08.31C. Today's gluon trials were a complete failure. Apparatus destroyed, no useful test data. Perhaps Dr. Klein was right. Another year's research down the drain. I had felt so sure of it. For my sake, I need success. But nothing is working. Not the gluon, nor the scabby. Even the confounded napkin bags. But what if I revisited an older project? No, definitely not. Perhaps, no. Wait, that's it. The shrink machine. Initial explorations had been promising before Dalton put the kibosh on it. I could set it up in the basement. If I showed that it worked, surely they could not argue with results. It's worth a try. What do I have to lose?
Okay, so that's number one. There's number two.
Dominant Practical Technologies, Dr. Wendell Tully, Science Division.
Ignore any of these noises that you're hearing.
87.12.19. Midnight now, but the covalent space reducer prototype is complete. Otherwise known as the shrinking machine, the spacer. I should get some rest, but the kids are already asleep. Trudy's given up and gone to bed, and I'm eager to find out if all these months of work were worth it. Everything should be sound, but you never know until you flip the switch. Well, here goes nothing. complete failure. Oh, why do I even try? I'll clean this mess up in the morning.
Okay, that's number two.
Supplemental log, ominous practical technologies, totally. Oh, whatever, I'll sort it later. The important thing is I have done it! Success! The spacer has worked its magic. I have successfully shrunk a set of basic plastic polyhedral dice from the size of standard dice to no bigger than the size of, well, much smaller dice. Burgle, make a note to come up with a better comparison.
Noting.
You did it. Nonetheless, this is a complete exoneration. However, it occurs to me that I have a new problem. The dice were intended to be young Fo's Christmas present. He will be disappointed. But perhaps I can convince him that they were miniature dice. The tiny instructions might be a bit of a giveaway. A new solution may be required. To the Fun Pit Toy Mart before they close.
That was number three. So now this is the spacer development. So I don't know how I don't have the first one, but I have all the others.
Circles for days now, and I've come to a decision. It's time to restart spacer development. Ominid may not believe in it, but I know its potential. Though I must figure out how to return shrunk objects to their original size. The first step will be to address the particle transcription errors. It seems almost certain that the irregularities are responsible for the failure during the demonstration. Burgle, please bring up all the lab data about the unknown particles.
Happy to be of service.
But I gotta stop this real quick.
Notes will be prepared and delivered to your table in 4 hours or less.
4 hours? What are the chances for less?
Delivery estimate will be prepared in 2 hours or less.
Auspicious beginning.
Okay, there's the first one of Ominid. Why am I over here if I'm gonna die?
I have isolated the source of the particle irregularities. They appear to be a byproduct of the shrinking process. If I adjust the machine to account for their existence, it should be the key to the de-shrinking, expanding process.
Crap.
Please bring up the readings for the irregular covalence SNPI.
Ignore this fight, just...
Z particle traces. That name is going to get tiresome. And while you're at it, rename all references to the irregular covalent SNPI for
number three.
One success after another. I have returned Burgle to his original size. It appears that my new raw science containment field is working at 99% effectiveness. There is some minor, insignificant raw science leakage, a note for another time.
Noted.
But I see no reason for a human trial. I believe there should be no issues. But, al dentes fortuna juat, I am ready to prove my creation's full potential. End recording. Burgle, I'd like to record some messages for my family, in case things do not go as planned.
Okay, there's that. And this is gonna be this one.
I was a fool to have ever doubted myself.
A fool like Klein, like Kaminsky, like Schmetter, like all of Abelot. I am here in the backyard. Down in the backyard. I mean, I am speaking to you from the backyard. I am tiny! I should gather my thoughts. This is a momentous occasion. I'm not only official as I take my first steps into the miniature world. For the backyard. The second lab is nestled into the hedge. Such wonderful views from up there. Side note, I'm worried that Dominant's shoddy manufacturing of the lab pieces will cause them to fall apart over time, but they will do for now.
steel cable are ridiculous, so I've been forced to proceed with my original idea, spider thread. I'm using web samples from my unwanted guests, with a few clever alterations, of course. Things were going well until Sarah threw yet another toy into the hedge. I swear that the lost city of Atlantis might be found beneath the roots of this blasted bush. I told them both. No baseballs, no flingman discs, no more throwing. I'll need to find a way to strengthen the zip lines, and I've forbidden the children from playing in the yard temporarily, of course. Dinner will be, I would say, awkward, I suspect. Slowly, my torments come together into one ingenious solution. After trying countless materials, I finally found something that fixed my zipline problem. While the bonding formulas were complex, to say the least, I succeeded in the web rope and raw science. Once again, it proves to be the key. The new ropes are miraculously soft, but have the tensile strength of forged steel. I dubbed my new creation Zippy Fiber. Just think of the practical applications.
Dental floss.
Oh, only something without gums would suggest that. This is not some trifle to pick parsley between trips to the periodontist.
I will take your word for it, Dr. Tully.
Hopefully this is explaining enough about the game as it goes on.
It is likely that this will be my last log from the hedge lab. Regrettably, the spider infestation is only worsened. Last night, I had a close encounter with a giant brood mother that shook me to my core. Couple that with the strange radio signals I've been receiving, and I no longer think this facility is safe. Teenagers, no. If this means that I must sacrifice 20 years of my life, and so be it.
business and running lab lockdown procedures. Wendell, out.
Scanning online. Transferring biometric data. Wendell Tully. Biometric data transfer complete. Audio file downloaded. Dr. Wendell Tully. Title. Goodbye.
Hello, my scabby wearing friend. I do not know who you are or how you came by this message, but please tell them I tried. Tell Trudy, Thor, my little Sarah. Tell the world. The sun is setting on our yard and it brings back so many memories. Sitting in this chair, my favorite chair, my thinking chair, I fear this may be the last time I lay eyes on such a beautiful sight. I'm nearly out of time. My body shrivels more with each passing day. Even my scabby can...
Okay, so there was all the cassette tapes. I hope you liked the video. Go ahead, and if you would like to, because I'm not really demanding, you can hit the subscribe button or like. That'd be helpful for me. But hope you have a good day, and see you next time.